If we could all stand again, we're going to go to the word of the Lord today. A couple of scriptures that are pretty familiar. And I would ask that if you've heard these scriptures before, and no doubt if you've been here any amount of time, you've heard these scriptures, but please don't tune out today because God wants to move. Acts chapter 1, verses 4 through 8. This is out of the New King James Version. Slightly different wording than the regular King James, but still the same concept. It says, "And beginning, being assembled together with them, he commanded them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, which he said, 'You have heard from me.' For John truly baptized with water, but you shall be baptized with the Holy Spirit not many days from now. Therefore, when they had come together, they asked him, saying, 'Lord, will you at this time restore the kingdom to Israel?' And he said unto them, 'It is not for you to know the times or the seasons which the Father has put in his own authority. But you shall receive power.'" Everybody shout power.
Power.
"After, when the Holy Spirit has come upon you, and you shall be witnesses to me in Jerusalem, in all Judea and Samaria, and to the end of the earth." Now we go to the next chapter, chapter 2, verses 1 through 4. And this is read out of the Passion Translation, and you can follow along either on the screen or in your translation. It says, "On the day of Pentecost, when the day of Pentecost was being fulfilled, all the disciples were gathered in one place. Suddenly, they heard the sound of a violent blast of wind rushing into the house from out of the heavenly realm." If you were around here yesterday, you heard the sound of violent rushing wind. "The roar of the wind was so overpowering, it was all anyone could bear. Then all at once, a pillar of fire appeared before their eyes. It separated into tongues of fire that engulfed each one of them. They were all filled and equipped with the Holy Spirit and were inspired to speak in tongues, empowered by the Spirit to speak in languages they never had learned." And then going further in that chapter, after Peter begins to preach to them, he says, chapter 2, verse 36, "Therefore, let all the house of Israel know assuredly that God has made this Jesus, whom you crucified, both Lord and Christ. Now, when they heard this, they were cut to heart." They were convicted. "And they said to Peter and to the rest of the apostles, 'Men and brethren, what shall we do?' Then Peter said to them, 'Repent, and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins.'" And I'm so glad it didn't stop there. And it says, "And you shall receive the gift of the Holy Spirit." And I'm so glad it just didn't stop there. He said, "For the promise is to you and to your children and to all who are afar off, as many as the Lord our God will call." And I will say today that he is calling to you. He's calling to you. If you've never received this gift of the Holy Ghost, he's calling to you today. If you've already received it, he's calling to you. Amen. You may be seated. My title for the message this morning is something that you will not understand right away, but it is this: force majeure. I got a lot of weird looks, but I will explain that here in just a moment. Force majeure. And I did Google it. That's the correct way that they pronounced it. So by way of introduction, we're nearing the end of hurricane season in 2022. Thus far in the United States this year, there have been 9 named storms, 4 hurricanes, and 2 major hurricanes. The most destructive hurricane this year was Hurricane Ian, which made landfall on the Gulf Coast of Florida as a Category 4 hurricane, and it was very close to a Category 5. No doubt some of you have experienced firsthand the devastation and the destruction that a hurricane can bring. A hurricane is a force of nature, and it is really more powerful than either you or I could even imagine. Now, I don't know if you're like me, but I have a weather app on my phone, and I have the notification set. It gives me a notification of any sort of thing that's happened weather related. If a tropical storm forms, it gives me a notification. It keeps me updated the progress if it turns into a hurricane, category 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I also get notifications of storms in the area and winds and all those things. And you know, when I just really couldn't help but take it as a confirmation to the message today, is that every day this week I've received some sort of weather-related notification on my phone. You know, before a hurricane even gets close to making a landfall, just like I spoke about, alerts are sent out to millions of people. And if it's coming to their affected area, if it's projected to hit their area, they begin to make preparations for the storm. Now, the same is true in the supernatural. Before a move of God comes, like the one we've been having here at Southland Tabernacle, there's always an alert that is sent out in the supernatural to the man of God if he is spiritually aware. I believe that we've been receiving notifications in the spiritual realm recently. And I am here today to sound the alarm and to alert you and to prepare you for a spiritual hurricane with a force that is greater than anything we've ever experienced before. And that is a force mature. Now, this force is nothing more than the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. We've recently been experiencing a mighty outpouring of the Holy Ghost at Southland Tabernacle. But I'm here to notify you today that a Holy Ghost hurricane is coming. And the category is unknown. Something like we've never seen before in this church, in this area. And it's going to wreak devastation and destruction upon the kingdom of the enemy. Praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. A force majeure. I'll explain to you what it is now. Some of you may already understand and know what it is, especially if you work in the business world. But it's a French term. Hey, getting experience, getting that right now. Amen. Well, the force majeure is a French term that literally means greater force. And contractually, in the business world, it's related to the concept of an act of God or an event for which no party can be held accountable, such as a hurricane or a tornado. In the business world, there is a force majeure clause in reference to a contract, but we will not focus on that part today. What we're going to focus on, the force majeure, is the greater force. Somebody shout, a greater force.
Greater force.
So in order to get the big picture, we really need to understand the magnitude and the force that is in a hurricane. Hurricanes release energy by their winds through the formation of clouds and rain. According to scientific research, just one average hurricane can release the equivalent to about 200 times the total electrical generating capacity on the planet. NASA says that during its life cycle, a hurricane can expend as much energy as 10,000 nuclear bombs. And we're not even talking about Hurricane Katrina here. We're talking about an average hurricane. As powerful as a hurricane can be, category 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As powerful as the forces of nature are, and as much energy and force that they can produce, they don't even begin to compare to the true force majeure, which is the Holy Ghost. I want to tell you today, if you have the Holy Ghost, you have a greater force inside of you. You have a greater force that is greater than 10,000 nuclear bombs. Think about the devastation and destruction you can release in the spirit world when you begin to speak in tongues, when you begin to release that force. The song was talking about release the sound. Somebody ought to release that sound today. Everybody under the sound of my voice, whether you are sitting here or you are sitting at home today, you should experience that force before you leave or before you tune out. We all need to be filled with the Holy Ghost today, which is that greater force. Hallelujah. Praise God. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus told his disciples that they would receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon them. But what exactly was this power for? There's several reasons for that power, but one main reason being is that it gives us the power to overcome sin. Romans 3:23 tells us, "For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God." Doesn't matter who you are, where you come from, who your mama, who your daddy is, what kind of family lineage you have, what pedigree you're from. It doesn't matter. None of that matters. The Bible tells us that all have sinned, and we all fall short of the glory of God. Romans 6:23 tells us, "For the wages of sin, the penalty of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus, our Lord." What is that gift of God? It is the gift of the Holy Ghost that enables us to achieve eternal life, that enables us to overcome sin. Galatians 5:19 through 21 tells us, "Now the acts of the flesh are obvious: sexual immorality, impurity, and debauchery, idolatry and witchcraft, hatred, discord, jealousy, fits of rage, selfish ambition, dissensions and factions." And it continues, "And envy, drunkenness, orgies, and the like. I warn you, as I did before, that those who live like this will not inherit the kingdom of God." So we must understand here today that each one of us have sinned. I would say that most of us here, there may be some angels among us, and if you are, then please tell us how to achieve that status. I would say that most of us here are guilty of at least one of those works that I just named at some point in our lifetime. But without a power, without a force that is greater than us, we could not achieve victory over sin and the promise of eternal life. The sobering truth is that sin will lead to a spiritual death, and sometimes it leads to a physical death. We can also observe that sin is a powerful force not to be taken lightly. You see, sin and selfishness, they go hand in hand. It was pride that caused Satan to try to exalt himself above Jesus, and thus he was kicked out of heaven. Satan tried to tempt Adam and Eve with self-exaltation in the Garden of Eden. He told them that if they ate of the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, that they would become like God. See, Satan tempts us with self. If you thought sin was hard to deal with, let me tell you today that self is one of the hardest things to overcome. And that is why repentance is absolutely necessary to receive the Holy Ghost. You can't skip repentance and think you're going to receive the Holy Ghost. You see, when we repent, we're literally dying out to self. And in that moment, when we repent, in that moment, we can have the power to overcome self, but it's not a sustained power. Repentance in itself is not salvation, because we don't have the power to consistently overcome sin and self. But there is a force. I'm happy to tell you this today, that there is a force that is greater than self. There is a force that is greater than sin, and the greater than the grip of sin in your life. And that force is the Holy Ghost. I want to tell you today that sin will take you farther than you want to go, and it will keep you longer than you want to stay. Sin will get you into messes you can't get yourself out of, and thus you begin to search for a way out of trouble. You begin to search, and you find yourself going deeper and deeper into a hole and into a pit of sin. And before you know it, you've gone so far that you feel you just can't take it anymore. You feel there's no hope left for you. And this is why some people attempt to take their lives, because they don't think that there is hope. They don't think that there's any force that's greater than their problem. They don't think that there's a force greater than depression and the anxiety that they feel. They feel so overwhelmed and so overcome with sin and with bondage and these things, and the worries and the cares of the world. They don't think that there's a way of escape. They don't think that there's something strong enough to pull them out of the pit that they have put themselves in. But I want to tell you here today, that if you are here because this is a last resort, I assure you, you've come to the right place. Because a greater force than your problem is here today. And that is the power of the Holy Ghost. And you can leave here with that greater force today. Hallelujah. There is hope for you. There is a greater force than your problem. There is a greater force than your current situation. Hallelujah. If you're here today and you're dealing with depression, if you're dealing with attacks in your mind, the enemy has been putting thoughts in your mind, why even go back to that church? You know you're going to leave just the same as you came. You know you've been to that church before and nothing's happened. Why go back to that church? But I want to tell you, don't listen to that voice today. I want to tell you is that if you will humble yourself and you will truly repent, God is able to deliver you. He's able to deliver you from depression. He's able to deliver you from anxiety. He's able to deliver you from that pit that you are in. You're not hopeless. You're not helpless. But I want to tell you today that you need to leave here with that greater force. You need to leave here speaking in other tongues as the Spirit gives you the ability. So why is the Holy Ghost so powerful? What makes it more powerful than nature, than sin and self? The answer is simply because that the Holy Ghost is, in fact, the Spirit of God, who is the very creator of nature. 2 Corinthians 3:17 tells us, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. That's why if you come in here today dealing with different things in your life, dealing with depression, anxiety, you feel a release because the Spirit of the Lord is here, and there is liberty in that, in this place. And you feel it all around you. But you see, the point is not to just feel it around you, but to get that inside of you so you can take it home with you, so you can experience victory every single day. Ezekiel 36:27 tells us, and I will put my Spirit within you and cause you to walk in my statutes, and ye shall keep my judgments and do them. The anchor truth is this: when we receive the Holy Ghost, we have the Spirit of the Almighty God living inside of us. We have the Spirit of the Creator of nature living inside of us. We have that greater force living in us. Another reason why we need the Holy Ghost is because the Spirit does what we are not capable of doing on our own. Romans 8:26 out of the Voice translation tells us a similar thing happens when we pray. We are weak and do not know how to pray. So the Spirit steps in and articulates prayers for us with groaning too profound for words. 1 Corinthians 14:2 tells us, "For he that speaketh in an unknown tongue speaketh not unto men, but unto God. For no man understandeth him, howbeit in the Spirit he speaketh mysteries." Something powerful happens when we relinquish control and we allow the Spirit to pray through us. When we truly pray in tongues, prayers that are too profound for words are prayed. When we have no idea, we have no idea just how much power is released when we pray in other tongues. There is a force that is greater than the force of 10,000 nuclear bombs when we pray in the Spirit. That force is here this morning. Jude 1:20, New Living Translation tells us, "But you, dear friends, must build each other up in your most holy faith. Pray in the power of the Holy Spirit." And an anchor truth is this: when you pray in the Holy Ghost, you are releasing a force into the atmosphere that is greater than the force of 10,000 nuclear bombs. When you pray in tongues, you're speaking mysteries in the spirit world. When you speak in that unknown language, as the Spirit gives you the ability, you're surrendering self and submitting to a greater force. And that force goes to work, and it begins to fight battles and win them that we could never win on our own. Ephesians 6:12 out of the Easy Read Version tells us, "Our fight is not against people on earth. We are fighting against the rulers and authorities and powers of this world's darkness. We're fighting against the spiritual powers of evil in heavenly places." No doubt there's many of you here today fighting battles, and you feel like you've not gaining ground. You feel like it's a battle that you're not winning, and you struggle, and you struggle, and you fought, and you prayed, but you're not winning this fight, and you feel like you're going backwards. Can I tell you today that perhaps you're trying to fight a spiritual battle by fleshly means? You can't win a spiritual battle by fleshly means. This is why we need the power of the Holy Ghost operating in our lives. That's why we need to pray in the Spirit. That's why we need to be renewed in the Holy Ghost every single day. Because we're fighting against the powers of darkness of this world. Young people, before you go to school, if you're filled with the Holy Ghost, you need to pray in other tongues before you go to school, because it gives you power and authority to defeat the rulers of darkness that are warring against you in that school. The good news is that if you've been struggling, if you feel like you have no power to overcome, if you're sick and tired of being sick and tired, and you can't seem to overcome self, there is a greater force that is here today. And you can have it. It is the Holy Ghost. The Bible warns us, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, walks about as a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour. I feel that there's people who've come into this place today. The enemy has tried to take you out because he sees your potential. The enemy has been warring against you. The enemy has sent a hurricane into your life, and he has convinced you that this force is greater than you, that this force is greater than anything, that there's no hope for you. But he's been telling you that because he knows that there is a greater force. He knows that that greater force is here today. And if you could get to this place today, that you could receive that greater force. The truth is that on our own, we cannot overcome sin. On our own, we cannot overcome self. On our own, we cannot overcome the forces of this world and of the forces of the enemy. But with the help of the Holy Ghost, nothing can stand in our way. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. You're not defeated. You're a child of God. You are more than a conqueror. You are an overcomer because you have the Spirit of God living inside of you. Somebody ought to release that sound right now. Come on. If you feel the Spirit moving upon you, go ahead and release that sound. Come on, continue in that vein. Continue in that vein. Hey, the forces of the enemy have been at work in this service. The enemy has tried to distract you. Come on, that's it. Keep on praying. Be in a spirit of prayer right now. God's about to move. We're overcoming the forces of darkness right now. The enemy has tried to convince you, even during this service, you don't need that. It's all just hype. You don't need the Holy Ghost. Oh, you've had the Holy Ghost, but you've never spoken in tongues. Oh, you don't need to speak in tongues today. That is a lie from the pits of hell, because the Bible tells us that when we receive the Holy Ghost, they spake with other tongues. Come on, that's it. If you have the Holy Ghost, you need to let that sound out right now. Come on, get in a mindset of prayer right now. Where are the intercessors at right now? Where are the prayer warriors at right now? There's a battle going on in the spiritual realm right now. But it's a battle that we can win. Some of you are engaged in something else right now. Some of you are putting your attention right somewhere else right now. You need to be putting your attention upon God. You need to be tuning in to what the Holy Ghost is doing right now, because there's spiritual battles being fought right now. There is a greater force, the Holy Ghost. Amen. Those who are praying, please continue to pray. I'm inviting everybody to stand right now. Please, those who are praying, continue to pray. I've done my best to prepare you for the outpouring of the Holy Ghost today, for the Holy Ghost hurricane that's about to hit in this place. You need to know this, that when you come to this altar, there's no addiction, there's no problem, there's no devil in hell that can stop you from receiving the Holy Ghost. The enemy can't touch you here if you don't want him to. He doesn't have power over you if you don't let him. Yes, 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 yes. Jesus, Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Amen. There's already people praying at this altar, and that is good. But everyone else who is not praying, I need you to listen. Please, those who are praying, please continue in that prayer. There is a sound that's about to be released in this house here today. Acts 4 and 31 tells us, and when they had prayed, the place was shaken where they were assembled together. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and they spake the word of God with boldness. Everyone here today should not leave without being filled with the Holy Ghost. If you've not already done it, I need you to tune in right now. Those who are praying, please, please continue to pray. But for everybody else, we're going to take self out of the equation right now. We're asking that everyone would join me right now, unless you're praying. And please join me in a prayer of repentance. We've got to get self out of the way. Right now, everybody in here that would, join me in a prayer of repentance. God, I surrender my will today. I repent of my sins, God. I relinquish control unto you. I give you control over my life today. In the name of Jesus. I repent of selfishness. I repent of self today. Lord, I give myself to you in Jesus' name. Come on, that's it. We're getting self out of the way right now. These altars are already filled with people. But if you're not in this altar and you've never received that experience of speaking in other tongues, I invite you to come to the altar right now. If you've never spoken in tongues, please come to this altar right now. And if it's been a while since you've spoken with other tongues, I invite you to come to this altar right now. You need to experience this force. And now I'm inviting members and guests, everybody who is not in this altar, I urge you to please come to this altar right now. Those who have the Holy Ghost, those who are who have the Holy Ghost and are not praying with people right now, I need you to listen. But if you're praying with people and you're praying, please go ahead. We need to release a sound today. There are spiritual battles being fought right now. If you have the Holy Ghost, as the Spirit of God gives you the utterance, in just a moment, we're going to release a shout, and you need to let those tongues out. Again, those who are not praying with other people, and you have the Holy Ghost, we're going to release a shout in just a moment on the count of three, and I want you to shout, and I want you to release the sound of the Holy Ghost. And this place is going to be shaken, and every person who has not experienced the Holy Ghost is going to speak in tongues in Jesus' name. Amen. Those who are ready, amen. On the count of three, I want you to release a shout, and then the Holy Ghost is going to be poured out in this place. One, two, three, release it. Jesus. Woo! Come on, go ahead and release those tongues right now. Amen.